Well, hello, third grade, and welcome back to school from home. I hope you had a nice Thanksgiving week vacation. I know that I did, and I'm ready to get back to work with you. So, this is the first of the videos that I've asked you to watch today. The first thing I want to do is talk through our new spelling list and just kind of make sure that you can read them and then talk about the patterns that we see. So, this week, our spelling patterns are OW and OU. And what we're practicing here is the OW and OU saying ow. And so I'm just going to read through these words, maybe talk about a couple of the meanings for you. And then your assignment today with these words is to write them three times each, like you'd normally do on Wednesday, but we're going to start out the week doing it on Monday. So we have clown, round, bow, cloud, power, crown, thousand, crowd, sound, count, powder, blouse. A blouse is actually like a kind of a dressy shirt. Usually it buttons up the front. Usually it's something that a lady would wear, or a girl, a pretty blouse. Frown, pound, house, found, mountain, which actually looks like mountain with the AI at the end. So that one might need a little extra studying. And then the word coward. You can see the chunk cow in there and then coward. A coward is a person who is the opposite of being brave. It's not being brave. Someone maybe who runs away from something, who kind of chickens out, would be called a coward. And then your two extra credit words we very likely have had before, but they're so important to learn how to spell. Our continent, North America, capital N, capital A, North America, two separate words, and then our planet Earth with a capital E. So if you have seen these before, maybe they'll be easier. So please write these three times each, save them on a piece of notebook paper, put them back in your envelope for me to check out. That would be great. I also want to introduce this week's story selection and just talk through the vocabulary. The story takes place in Japan. It is a Japanese tale called The Kamishibai Man. Kamishibai. And I know I could say that 10 times and it's going to be hard for you to remember. I am going to give you a YouTube video to follow along with today. It's not me reading it, but I would like you to open up your Journeys book when we're done here and find the Kamishibai Man. And then, if possible, follow along with that video reading to you and hopefully hearing it will help you. So I just want to go over some of the vocabulary words that you are going to run into this week. The first one is the word familiar. This illustration is from a familiar or well-known story. It is from Cinderella. If something is familiar, you have seen it before. Familiar means something that is known because it is experienced often. You might see a person on the street and think, oh, he looks familiar. I've seen him before. Or food that you're familiar with, you have eaten before. The second word is the word applause. It's not applesauce, it kind of looks like it, but applause, clapping. At first, the applause was soft, then the clapping grew louder. Applause is clapping. People clap to show that they like something. We're going to keep moving because this video will get long fast. This is the word vacant. This old movie theater is vacant. Nobody comes here anymore. Vacant simply means empty. There's a vacant parking lot in the story. And you'll meet the main character who goes there, where he used to tell stories years ago. Then we have the word rickety. Rickety, rickety. Some puppet theaters are rickety, not sturdy, and can easily collapse. Rickety means shaky or likely to fall apart, like an old rickety bridge. It's not very sturdy anymore. Blurry. There's a bossy R word with the UR saying blurry. When a sad movie makes you cry, everything looks blurry or fuzzy. Blurry means unclear or smeared. My glasses get blurry. and I need to stop and clean them. Or if I've been crying, if I'm sad and there are tears in my eyes, I might not have clear vision. So it would be blurry. Blasted, base word blast. Blasted means it happened in the past. Horns blasted loudly during this school concert. Blasted means made a sudden loud sound, like a horn blasting. If I'm remembering right, in the Kamishibai Man, he's riding on his bicycle through the busy city traffic, and there are horns blasting. They blasted at him because he shouldn't be on a bicycle on that busy street, so they were honking their horns. Word number seven is the word jerky. This is not the kind of jerky you eat. We've been talking about venison jerky at our house this week. This is a different one. This dance uses quick jerky motions that stop and start back up again. Jerky means moving in sudden, uneven, or awkward ways. Jerky is not smooth. It's just kind of rough and maybe not very coordinated. Awkward is a good word to remember for jerky. All right, then we have the last word, rude. I know you've heard this word before. It is very rude or impolite, which means not polite, to talk during a movie or a play. Rude means not being polite or having bad manners. So with that, you have been introduced now to our vocabulary words, and I would like you to find your Journeys book and open up to the Kamishibai Man. And then if you are able to, click the YouTube link under my instructions for the Kamishibai Man and follow along. You can read that this week as many times as you want. Reading it multiple times would be great. Read it to someone and use that video as many times as you would like. We will be talking about the story later this week like we always do, so that will come. But use the videos if you can, because they are here to help you. So enjoy writing those spelling words three times each, and I hope you enjoy the Kamishibai Man.